along on our website, or if you're not getting information, just fill out those forms that are on your chairs. And so at this time, as most of you know, 2 weeks ago on Martin Luther King Day, our choir, along with several others, performed at Carnegie Hall. With God, they say, all is truly possible. Several of you attended and supported them, and all of you prayed for them. Prayer works. It's remarkable. Rob and I also had the great joy of attending. Upon entering Carnegie Hall, there is a large plastic container. It's about this big, and it's filled to the brim with offerings for the patrons. The container is, in fact, filled with cough drops. It is there as a gift for the audience and those that are performing. It's a means of not detracting from the performance. But of course, church is far different. In church, there are ringing cell phones and folks fidgeting and fiddling in their purses, and things are happening and chairs are being set up. And there's pots and pans that we sometimes get from the kitchen. Sounds of distraction seemingly detracting from our ability to worship. Yet the daily noises of our lives, the seeming annoyances, are what we each of us contend with as we seek the holy in our lives. There is no cough drop made that can still the noise around us, and at times the noise in our own heads. So as people of faith, we must be intent on listening, because it is in the midst of chaos that God often creates. So as you hear the beautiful noise of children, hands in the kitchen, and people whispering, try also to hear God's inspiration in the words and the music of the choir. It might just change you forever. God of complex melodies. Please stand.
God of complex melodies, you call us together. Altos, sopranos, tenors, and bass, different yet complementary, composed by your love and grace, longing to be attuned to your spirit.
Be with us this morning. Forgive us when we are off key, and embrace our effort as we seek to live in harmony with all humanity and with you, God. Help us to hear you and follow you as you orchestrate beauty in our lives and world. Amen.
Holy, holy, holy,
Gracious God, may the words of our mouths, the meditations of our hearts, be acceptable to you, O God, our rock and our redeemer. Amen.
Good morning. A reading from Romans chapter 8, verses 24 through 27. For in hope we are saved. Now hope that is seen is not hope. For who hopes for what is seen? But if we hope for what we do not see, we wait for it with patience. Likewise, the Spirit helps us in our weakness. For we do not know how to pray as we ought. But that very Spirit intercedes with sighs too deep for words. And God, who searches the heart, knows what is the mind of the Spirit, because the Spirit intercedes for the saints according to the will of God. And we know that all things work together for good to them that love God, to them who are called according to God's purpose.
The story of our community is one of leaps of faith, the impossible becoming possible. That is also the story of our choir going to Carnegie. We leap together, and New York caught us. With God's help, of course. We trusted in the Holy and watched as remarkable, beautiful, inspiring, awesome things began to transpire. Today, choir members will share how their experience in New York had a profound effect on their faith and their craft. You will hear differing intonations, but their stories all hold the harmonies of all people of faith. This journey changed us for the good, and we hope it'll inspire you as well.
Ask almost any New Yorker how to get to Carnegie Hall, and they will respond with the time-honored punchline, practice, practice, practice. As a born and bred New Yorker, I know you can get to Carnegie Hall via Uber, subway, or walking. But singing at Carnegie Hall is another story. Like my faith, singing at Carnegie Hall required me to act, even when afraid, to take directions, even when I may disagree or not understand, to blend my voice with others, desiring to use whatever gift God has given me as a means of celebrating life and being of service, sharing in our Lord's wondrous and many blessings. Out of your prayer, some planning, and lots of practice, grew love and understanding between our diverse members. We are a better choir because of our shared experience. I never thought I would dream in Latin, but for weeks now, the Latin language and an incredible musical score have been the center of my dreams. How blessed am I?
As a former New Yorker,
by way of a Holland Tunnel,
or Jersey, New Jersey, I know the old joke about getting to Carnegie. But as many of you know, the composer Kim Andreassen asked us to perform with other choirs from across the globe his piece Requiem, a piece we had performed in part the last Palm Sunday. Who knew where that would lead?
God.
Yeah, of course God. Arneson says, as a composer, I believe in music's power to heal and to give us a transcendent and transformative experience. Music can connect us to each other and remind us to be compassionate to others and to ourselves.
As you listen this morning,
as you take in the power of the music,
may it transform you as it did me.
And me.
And all of us.
Amen.
Thank you.
7, verses 7 through 11. My heart is steadfast, O God. My heart is steadfast. I will sing and make melody. Awake, my soul. Awake, O harp and lyre. I will awake the dawn. I will give thanks to you, O Lord, among the peoples. I will sing praises to you among the nations. For your steadfast love is as high as the heavens. Your faithfulness extends to the clouds. Be exalted, O God, above the heavens. Let your glory be over all the earth.
Every experience one has changes them. I recognize that I'm changed by things that impact me every day through thoughts, words, and deeds. I also recognize that my words and actions, my voice, my gifts, can enhance God's voice if lifted in unison with others. God is at Carnegie and is with us this morning. And through this experience, I am yet again forever changed. Reflecting on my experience performing with the group, one of the deepest impressions I have ties directly to my Christianity. Working through this very difficult piece, I realized that the quintessential experience revolved around the whole being greater than the sum of its parts. As scripture says, "And we know that all things work together for good to them that love God, to them who are called according to God's purpose." Our individual talents became supernaturally powerful when placed together. In communion with others is when I am at my best. Our youngest member and senior member both stated that they were blessed and perhaps more importantly, changed by this experience. One stating, "I felt connected and not alone." Choirs came from Italy, Austria, and the U.S. Professionals and non-professionals, young and old, differing gifts and abilities, differing languages, challenged in a variety of ways, yet trusting in the journey and joined in one common purpose. And as another stated best, "I thank God for music."
How many notes does it take to make a piece of music touch your soul? Well, it's hard to say, isn't it? But one thing is for sure, it takes more than one. One note played repeatedly would not inspire me, move me, or even bring joy to my soul. But many notes, melodies, instruments, and artists can, and did, create what I alone could not have imagined. One choir member said, "Never did I think I would sing at Carnegie Hall. I sang with care and conviction, and my daughter was able to see it." For me, I had never appreciated New York the way I did on this trip. To have the privilege of singing with so many talented musicians from all over the world was both a joy and an honor. The free expression of moving music and collaboration transcends language and distance. It is what I embrace from this experience, to hear our diverse voices joined together, bouncing off the walls of Carnegie Hall, reflecting God's beauty in that lovely piece of Arneson's Requiem is a beauty beyond words.
was especially moved by the next part of the Requiem, which you will hear. The beauty and poignancy of the text in the last movement, speaking of those who have died, so long as we live, they too shall live. Every time I read this or sing it, it stirs the emotions about loved ones who have died, yet live on in our hearts and therefore our lives. It is also a reflection of the traditional Latin text from the first movement, et lux perpetua luceat eis, that perpetual light shine upon them, as we remember.
Ray and I have been worshiping for a year today with the chancel choir of Church by the Sea. We have been really blessed to be part of this choir. Going to New York to sing at the Carnegie Hall has been a lifetime dream come true. The comrade shared among the choristers was unsurpassed. In the piece you heard from Dickinson's poem, she writes and we sing, if I can ease one life from aching. While in New York, in between rehearsals, we had the chance to visit the 9/11 memorial, specifically to visit the site where the name of my cousin, Aileen Fletcher, is found. She died during the 9/11 attack of the Twin Towers. We had always wanted to go there and look for her name, but had never been able to do so until now. Being part of this great family made this wish come true. Even though it proved to be somewhat sad, it provided peace and closure. We are deeply thankful for easing that ache. For another member of her choir, her sister has been diagnosed with breast cancer. Her sister sat in the audience and found its inspiration. As she enters chemo this week, we pray our voices of prayer and song will ease any ache. I developed pneumonia during the treatment, and even that did not diminish my enthusiasm and joy during our stay in New York. In the midst of everything, we saw God's hand, love, and power.
Thank you from the bottom of our hearts, Church by the Sea. At this time, we invite you all to offer one another a sign of the peace of Christ as we seek to ease another's ache.
Peace with you all. Birthday share. Piegesu,
thorny. And I drank of hope's memorial as sunset's reflection flared. Dona eis requiem.
Today we lift up all who need to be remembered. The poor, the hungry, the homeless, those waiting to hear about their immigration status, and those who will decide. Give me the strength to act, to speak, to sing in ways that eases another's life. Help us all to live so your melodious sounds are heard above the outcry of war and racism, abuse and injustice. So one ache can be eased, or two or more. That harmony can be heard among nations and people, within families, and within our own hearts, we pray. This morning, we especially pray for the members of our own community, for those who are remembering, for Maria's father, Angel Loomis, on his passing this week. May perpetual light shine upon him, and may his family find comfort as they grieve his loss and remember the loss of their mother. We pray for Jean Brian, his father, as he's having heart surgery this morning. For Amy as she begins chemotherapy. For Reverend Rob's dad, who is awaiting a pacemaker. For all who are sick and suffering, may your healing light be upon them, God. And as we begin classes in English and in Spanish, may your light be upon us as a community as we seek compassion for those that are similar and different from ourselves. In a time of silence, we lift up all our concerns in between the quiet. Together yet in one voice we say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever.
Some of the titles of the songs that we've sung all through the 4 years that I've been here, I remember the faces of all those people who approached me, that they have been touched and blessed by our music. Growing up in a small town from the Philippines, I have never thought that I would move to the United States, nor live in Florida, and perform at Carnegie Hall. I remember when I was young, I used to talk about this with my classmates at school when I was in college. So it was really a great experience for me and for all of us here at all the Chants of Choir members. So we all would like to thank our church, the Church by the Sea, and all the board members, and all you, the congregants of this church, for giving us the opportunity that we will never remember, we will never forget, but we will remember for the rest of our lives.
Jennifer and I have been members of the choir and the music committee for many years. When I first heard that we were going to sing in Carnegie Hall, I was absolutely thunderstruck. I couldn't believe it. And I thought back to the time that we actually sang the Requiem here for a worship through music. I was touched then so much that we could offer such glory to God and enhance our congregation's worship experience. Performing this glorious music in Carnegie Hall with the fantastic people in our choir truly was the highlight of my life. The experience solidified our love for each other. Having friends from the church attend was such an honor. Knowing that the church supported us financially made it possible. Your generosity lifted a huge burden off of me. And many of us, so that we could focus on creating the beauty. When we sang, I felt that our love and joy soared to the heavens, and God's love was palatable all around us. As I remember that moment, I am still brought to tears, as you can tell. I am honored and humbled that we were afforded this opportunity.
Your generosity allows God to bring beauty, love, and light into a world in need. It brings people of faith together. It enhances lives in ways we can hardly express. Your offerings support such events. Our youth and mission programs of this church let us continue to make music together. I invite the deacons to come forward and take this morning's offering.
Thank you. they said, just a moment. When we marched onto that stage, we were in long lines, but somehow I ended up four rows back, exactly in the middle, where the choir director could see me very clearly. In the rehearsals, he had said, get your heads out of your books and look at me. So I felt a special responsibility to represent our choir in getting our heads out of the books and watching very closely his directions. And the reason I'm back here, because it's easier for me to speak from this microphone than to wander down to the one in front. And so I must confess that a lot of times I can't even see her. Never mind, let's do it in my head. So it was a real experience for me to be confronted by the director, who is close as Charlie was, maybe standing. Anyway, it was a great experience. And you've heard our individual testimonies to the love we shared, to the gratitude that we felt. And so let's now pause for a moment of thanksgiving. Dear God, awesome and wonderful, we come before you with thanksgiving deep in our hearts and with tokens of our gratitude expressed through the life of this church. We thank you for the love that you have brought to this community of faith and inspired it to be so generous in sending its senior choir up to Carnegie Hall. We thank you for all who have made that gift to us responsible, and we as a choir express our deep thanksgiving and our attempt to be harmonious with each other and calling upon you, God, and our world to be harmonious with all peoples, that indeed we might fulfill our mission of bringing peace and joy, love and music to the world. Amen.
I invite you to remain standing as we start our closing hymn, but also I want to invite you to remain seated after the closing hymn for not only the benediction, but for the postlude. And I must add one little thing, that as Rob and I stand and watch this glorious choir, I kept looking and seeing Reverend Bird. And for me, the idea of a man that has given his life in service to others, that at 91 stood proudly in the middle of that choir, no coincidence, and represented our church and has sung in two choirs, not for any reason other than enhance your worship and for the glory of God, we are truly blessed, but it is our turn to clap for you. Join us in singing Send Forth by God's Blessing.
Praise God, who welcomes one and all. Praise Christ, who loves both great and small.
Make us one whole from every part. Teach us your purpose and your way, so we might serve you every day.
Praise God, who guides us each day to what beauty and peace express in unimagined ways.
And until we meet again along the way, may God hold and keep you and every day. Amen.